गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, कैन यू हियर मी क्लियरली?
हेलो, यस वी कैन हियर,
गुड आफ्टरनून, यस मनीष.
सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद आवर सेशन. ओके, माय सेल्फ मनीष कोरिया, एज्योर टेक कम्युनिटी ऑर्गेनाइजर, वेलकम्स यू ऑल फॉर टुडेज वेबिनार ऑन डिजाइनिंग एंड एज्योर डेटा सॉल्यूशन डीपी 201 सर्टिफिकेशन. सो वी विल स्टार्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट आवर टुडेज सेशन. Today's session is organized by ATC community and sponsored by Synergetics and Microsoft. Our ATC community, can you see my presentation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, we can. Yes.
Okay, thank you. Our ATC community is open to all the people who are interested in Microsoft Cloud technologies. You just need to follow our meetup groups, which is Emerging Technology Community Mumbai, Azure Tech Community Pune, Azure Tech Community Surat, Azure Tech Community Nagpur, and Artificial Intelligence AI on Microsoft platform. You just need to install the meetup app in your mobile and follow our communities, so you will be updated our latest events, meetups, webinars, workshops, and latest offers also. This is a small code of conduct that you all need to follow. Please note that you can't take screenshots of the presentation and can't do screen recording also. If you need recording, then simply subscribe our YouTube channel. We will sharing you YouTube channel link in chat box later. Today's session is all about designing an Azure Data Solutions DP 201 certification exam. Our agenda is orientation of DP 201, module overview of DP 201, use cases, and demonstrations. We believe that today's webinar knowledge takeaways will be overview of Azure data storage solutions, overview of data processing solutions, and last, overview of data security and compliance. Today's speaker for the webinar is Mr. Chandrasekhar Deshpande. Mr. Chandrasekhar is data all-rounder with unique blend of experience in multitude of data-related technologies. He is having huge experience, which is more than 30 plus years in the tech corporate industry. Chandrasekhar is a Microsoft certified trainer. He is specialized in many technologies such as big data, analytics, machine learning, Azure, Hadoop. Also, he has worked with many Fortune companies like Accenture, Infosys, L&T, Syntel, and many more others. This is our course calendar, from you, which anyone certification courses you can do with flat 50% discount, which makes its final fees rupees 17,500 only plus tax. Okay, then next is our current webinar series calendar. Our next session session calendar will be announced soon. So please get a timely update and like our or follow our communities and social media platforms. This is our current webinar series. This is our here is the certification for today's webinar. attendee. Okay, please note that attendees have to submit, means attendees have to submit their feedback form to get this certificate. Again, we will be sharing the feedback form link in the chat box later. Now, today's special announcement is we are giving Microsoft sponsored exam vouchers to 5 lucky winners. These winners will be selected from feedback form itself. So please share your feedback form before leaving the session. Now I would like to Chandrasekhar sir to hand over. Chandrasekhar sir, please proceed to with your session. Thank you everyone. Thank you once again.
Thanks Manish. Chandrasekhar here, and I welcome from the bottom of the heart everybody here in this session. As Manish told, I do have experience in analytics, and I'm regularly conducting sessions on analytics and certification, Microsoft certification sessions also. I would like to share my screen. Manish, will you please allow me to share the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you can share your screen now.
Just a minute. Okay, so as far as data processing is concerned, Microsoft is really diligent about it, and has started introducing lots of data processing, analytics, machine learning, deep learning services on the Azure cloud, and they are really diligent about introducing examinations, lots of examinations and certifications they have introduced to help to groom the society and all the technical guys into analytics, as well as in recent market trends, recent business trends. As on today, if you see, as an individual, what I can say is this technology is very much demanding, and it is one of the most lucrative technologies as on today. Every day we can see a growth of around 7 to 8%. Would like to check with everybody whether I am audible properly and I am able to reach to everybody. Please let me know whether my screen is also reaching.
Yes.
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 Thanks all.
Just and if possible, can you full screen your presentation?
Sorry.
Can you run your presentation in presentation?
Yes, I can. Just a minute. I can run it. Just a minute. Slideshow. Now is it properly visible? All font sizes are visible.
Yes.
Yes.
Thanks,
yeah.
Thanks, yes. All. So industry is sensing the growth of 7 to 8% consistently in couple of past years, and industry is predicting this a similar growth to continue in coming years also. One of the most lucrative profession as on today. And just observe Gartner and other analytical firms which are publishing their observations and market surveys time and again. Okay, they are predicting a huge growth in between 21 to 22. So here these predictions were done previous to last year. I will say because of this pandemic, these predictions have got delayed by around an year. Okay, so you can read instead of 2021 here, you can read 2022, and here you can read 2023. So these graphs still are valid. Only the thing is there is some kind of a break and a delay in overall market situation. Okay, but just try to see, everybody is predicting huge leap in the coming year. huge leap in this coming year. And you know, being an individual, being a professional, you know, we can get ourselves ready to meet the challenges this industry is posing to us. As far as different industries are concerned, here, you know, blue color is representing service industry, black is representing hardware industry, and gray color is represented by software industry. So here you will see growth in service industry is not much expected in coming years. So it's in billions only. Just few billions growth is predicted in service industry, few billions growth is predicted in hardware industry, but much more growth is predicted in software industry compared to hardware and service industry. So this growth definitely is bringing a kind of a wave in the market. Every firm will start using analytics for the management decision purpose. That is one thing, and every company will try to introduce their new spectrum of product for their clientele to use. Okay, so in hospital industry, in finance industry, in every industry, this particular analytics is expected to bring overhauling and path breaking growth. So many companies have started, they have pulled up their socks, and many companies have started, getting aligned with the new challenges and trying to introduce a kind of analytics in their products, image processing or text analysis in their products. So they already have started introducing it. Every company, as on today, every company may not be needing analytics skill sets, but tomorrow every company is definitely in the need of analytics skill sets. As far as this whole spectrum is concerned, there is entirely different ecosystem. There are lots of new roles, new challenges, new responsibilities, new set of frameworks, new set of softwares, new set of tools, lots of things. Whole entirely new ecosystem is getting evolved here. As far as data engineer is concerned, he is responsible for provisioning the infrastructure. Now again, this cloud also has brought entirely new set of skills, new set of tools, new set of knowledge in this industry. So many companies are migrating their products on cloud, or developing their new products altogether on the cloud. So provisioning infrastructure means provisioning on premise as well as provisioning on cloud. Data wrangling, depending on what kind of data it is and what is the current quality of the data. You have to have very good quality of the data to use it in the processing and to use it in the analytics, to get accurate results. So data cleaning, increasing the quality of the data, data transformation, those are new kind of skills to be acquired by a professional. We call it as a data wrangling. Okay, so depending on the existing quality of the data, depending on from what sources data is being procured, different measures are applied to wrangle the data and to produce the data to make it up to the mark for analytical processing. Actual process implementations, again, different kinds of compute solutions are to be applied here. Security is being increased. Monitoring, security and monitor anyway are unavoidable part of any enterprise level application development. Non-functional factors are also to be considered, like disaster recovery and backups and recovery, all those things. So data engineer role is responsible for all of these. Okay, and as far as this data engineer is concerned, why I'm talking about the data engineering, it is because this DP201, basically this certification is for a skill set of data engineer. Okay, so in case if you are not data engineer, you can reskill yourself very quickly okay, and can get yourself certified in DP 200 and 201, you know, to start getting the responsibilities of data engineer on your shoulders. Developer can easily, you know, reskill himself or herself into data analytics role. It is because developer somehow comes from the development background. He is very good and proficient in writing the application in some programming language. More or less, these programming languages are, you know, similar. You know, what we call it the logic. Every programming language needs a logic. Only programming language changes, comes with a new set of tools and a new set of syntaxes. But otherwise, one and the same. For the developer, you know, aligning himself into this new role or reskilling himself into this new role is not a big deal. Okay, just would like to check with everybody. Okay, from all of us, how many of us, whether Manish is there, can Manish give me a quick answer? How many of us are from the development background? Manish, do we have any idea? Hello. Let me just check how many of us are from the development background. Yes, I got 5 replies, 6, 7, 8. Wow, finding difficult to count. Okay, but it seems that many of us are from development background. But yes, I have a point to make that if you are from database background or if you are from testing background, you know, I do have, you know, solution and suggestion for you also. So be there. Okay, this certification is not only for the guys who are coming from the development background. Okay, but yes, many, many of us are from this background. Thanks. Yes, so as on today, you know, some of you maybe are from .NET, some of you maybe are from Java, some of you maybe are from development of scripting language. Okay, you will find getting yourself molded into this role, okay, not much challenging. Easy transition to another development platform. Now here, if you see, Python is one of the most popular language in analytics. Okay, Java does have lots of libraries. Python being Python does have, you know, small learning curve. And that's why, you know, Python is a first choice for the developers, you know, to choose and do the development in analytics. But yes, there are similar languages too. Like Scala is also equally simple to work with. Okay, R language needs some in-depth study of the mathematics, but some of you might be aware of the R also. If you are from engineering background, you know, going for R is not a big deal for you. Okay, whatever be the basic mathematical knowledge, what you need in R language is, you know, dealing with the mathematics and dealing with the polynomials and, you know, quadratic and simultaneous equations and probability as well as set theory. Okay, only these topics are necessary. Okay, for I just got one message. Let me just check. Okay, Mr. Kumar is from Dev. Okay, fine. Yes. So if you are from engineering background, going for these languages is not a much challenging for you. If you are from development background, you know, in case if you are not, you know, you want to learn Python, you know, it's really easy for you to learn Python. Okay, what I remember is within 3-4 days, you know, you can easily learn Python. Just within 3-4 days, you can learn Python, not a big deal. Somehow for DP 201 as well as for DP 200, you don't need, you know, much knowledge of Python. Okay, because you know, for customization, you have to know the language. Okay, but otherwise, so many tools are available where if you want to, your need is standard, you know, going with that tool and doing the development is very simple for you. Okay, so for DP 201 and DP 200, and the knowledge of in-depth knowledge of Python is not necessary. Aware of nitty-gritty of end-to-end design, development, deployment, and production lifecycle, yes. With availability of different libraries, drag and drop, ready-to-use features make work simpler and quicker. Do not need much mathematical and statistical background. Okay. In case if you want to go with a R language, then mathematical and statistical background is necessary. In case if you want to go to the next stage of machine learning, there also some knowledge of mathematics is necessary. But for DP200 and DP201, that knowledge is not much needed. In case if somebody from you are from the database background, let me just check with you. How many of us are from the database background? Okay, you will have to just first of all keep your hand down and then would like to know how many of us do have the database background. Now it is very difficult for me to know who all are from database background. Okay, it seems around 10 of us are from database background. Okay, no issue. So again, if you are from database background, you know, you can easily go for DP200 and DP201. Basically, you know, these DP200 and DP201, they are talking, all these certifications are talking about, you know, big data processing. So data processing is a part of the analytics. Earlier, we used to do the data processing using RDBMS, but now here we are using multiple tools to do a similar kind of data processing. So, and these different services which are available on the cloud, like Cosmos DB, like SQL Data Warehouse, like, you know, Azure Databricks, all these services allow us to execute the query to procure the information. And the query is similar to SQL. So if you are from database background and you're very, you know, confident and comfortable, on querying the data source, okay, here you will find the similar things. So scripting like languages like Python, Scala are much simpler. Again, Python and Scala like languages, learning Python and Scala like languages is not mandatory here. But if you learn them, okay, it will add, you know, teeth to your set of tools. Okay, and if you learn, you know, you can do the customization challenges. You can meet the customization challenges easily. Learning Python and Scala-like languages, again, is not a big challenge. Okay, it's really easy to learn these languages, a matter of 3 to 4 days. For somebody, it will be a matter of 5 to 6 days, not more than that. After all, data processing is a major part of the analytics. Technology is much familiar to DBAs, developers. Okay, and that's why, you know, in case if you are from database background, you know, flourishing in this field, okay, and showing your caliber in this field is not very much odd against your earlier skill set. Okay, it is as per your skill set only. If you are from tester background, okay, then also many tools are available here, which are like, you know, graphical tools, drag and drop. So without writing a code, you know, even non-developers also, the people who are coming, who are working in the managerial area, for them also, you know, doing the analytics is not a big deal. So if you are a manager, you are from, you know, management background, you have forgotten, you know, this development and RDBMS. Again, so nice tools are available here where, you know, with a drag and drop, you can wrangle the data. With a drag and drop, you can create machine learning models also. Okay, and multiple machine learning models you can create by just doing a drag and drop. You can compare them. You can choose the best one. And that best one you can ask, you know, deployer to deploy for you. Okay, so lots of things you also, even if you are from non-development background, you can do. So for the testers also, because of the availability of lots of drag and drop tools, ready libraries. Okay, your work is very simple. Okay, easy acquaintance to the development platform is possible if you are coming from white box testing background. If you are coming from white box testing background, you know, you are habitual to look at the code and understand it. You are habitual to do, you know, changes of just few lines in the code. Okay, so again, you know, in case if somebody of us are from the testing background, you will realize not a big challenge here. As on today, what is happening is we want to have our good footprint on, you know, social media. OK, so LinkedIn. Now there are around 660 million members from around 200 countries on LinkedIn all over the world. You know, many members keep giving the, you know, search specifically if a member is from HR background, he or she keeps giving the search and he can see who all are there in this area, who all are working in this area. OK, so in order to make our profile, you know, strong, we have good opportunity to go for the certifications. OK, and even when we modify LinkedIn profile, our name, our profile appears in many of the searches. OK, so it increases the social presence. It gives us opportunity also appearing for such certifications, what I'm talking about. Appearing for such certifications give us opportunity, you know, to go for challenging assignments. You know, we may be chosen from our offices or from our company. We may be chosen for going for online attending the conferences. As of now, you know, foreign tours will be forbidden for few more months, but you know, later we can see our profile is you know, competing with the profile of our colleagues, which will add, you know, value to our profile and our profession also. Proud moment for lucrative gains. Okay, so many companies do have you know, kind of a policy that if you complete a certification, you will be entitled for some rights. Microsoft privileges and benefits. I did certifications. I have done around, say, 8 to 9 certifications. Okay, and I am enjoying the privileges given by Microsoft. So many tools Microsoft has given me without charging for the installation. So I have been given for the licenses of those tools. I have been given you know, access to the Azure, annual access to the Azure. And you know, every month Azure used to deposit 7,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees to my credit, and I can practice on Azure, you know, as much as of you know, 7,000 rupees. I can do that. So all those are, you know, privileges and benefits what Microsoft offers to use. Increase your visibility and broad knowledge set, validate your knowledge and skills. As on today, many companies have started, you know, accepting cloud-based projects also, where, you know, such type of certification, such type of knowledge becomes very important. As far as DP-201 certification is concerned, we will talk about DP-201 certification specifically. But before that, I would like to check with everybody. Is it understood? Or do you have any question on what topics I have covered up till now? Anybody from us are from the testers background? I think somebody is there from, no, nobody is from the testers background. Okay, just would like to know any question on whatever I have covered up till now. General question answer session.
Yes. Hi, Sanjay. Yes. So I have a question. Saying that you stated that the amount of Python, can you just give me a map, like how much Python is required, or any specific way we can learn, like, you know, you don't have to go through the complete whole Python part, just like 8 to 10 services or calls or something like that can work upon. So is there any map for that?
You mean what we need to get ready or work in the Python to make ourselves ready for analytics?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Basic Python.
So any specific topics within Python? Because Python is as like easy but vast as well, right? So
yes, I'm mentioning here. So basic Python means a program constructs and diction, program collection, language collections. You know, that is basic Python. How do we handle exception? How do we do IO? That is basic Python. Okay. At the top of it, what you know, libraries we need to get ready to work with: NumPy, Pandas. And if you want to go with a machine learning or advanced analytics, then you have to have scikit-learn. These many things are at least needed. These many things are at least needed. Okay, now in order to get ready on, now whenever I'm talking about basic Python, let me just mention few of the points here. Program constructs, language constructs, program constructs, then comes collections, IO, then comes exceptions, lists, collections. I already have taken collections, so I am removing list from here. Anything? Yes, package and modules. Packages and modules. Anything anybody can add here? Have I missed any point here? NumPy represent arrays and matrices. Arrays and matrix. That's why matrix.
NumPy. And functions also in this list.
Yes. Functions. Hello? Somebody else also tried to suggest me something?
You request SciPy on.
SciPy, at the top of SciPy, you know, scikit-learn and NumPy had been built. So SciPy may be needed once in a while. Okay, but here I am not mentioning.
Fine, yeah.
As far as pandas are concerned, there is something called as a data frame. Okay, this data frame is actually a columnar representation of the data. Columnar representation of data. And why it is important in analytics? Because, you know, all those data structures which are representing data in columnar form are important for analytics. And that's why this data frame is also important for analytics. Okay, so scikit-learn, for example, you know, scikit-learn provides us lots of analytical functions, ready functions, and all those analytical functions mostly work on data frame. So scikit-learn offers analytics and machine learning. Okay, so for analytics and machine learning, Pandas data frame is a good option to go with. Have I answered your question?
Yes, thank you.
Anybody has any other question? Please let me know. I got one other question. Just a minute. Least array functions, OOPS concepts. I don't think OOPS concepts are necessary. Least array and functions. Yes, function I have mentioned here. Okay. Arrays are part of NumPy and list is a part of the collection. So in collections, you know, list comes there, list comes, set comes, dictionary comes, And there are lots of other, you know, collections, which here I'm mentioning the small list only. Okay, so list is already there inside collection. Huh? Hello? Somebody wants to say something?
I mean, we can also add the constructors and generators part also, but I think that is not comes in basic Python, so we can avoid.
Generators, yes, generators can be used here. Generators, we can use generators here. Okay, besides that, randomization functions, you know, string manipulation, string manipulation, okay, including regex, randomization. So yes, means bits and parts from, you know, these things also are necessary. Here I will mention string manipulation and regex as a major part here, because, you know, text analysis has to be done using string manipulation and regex only. So these are, yes, some of the parts, these parts are also important there. Okay, so that much is a thing of Python you need to work on, work upon.
Sir, I have a question. Myself, I'm Kamesh. So this DP200 or 201 basically involves the, like, building the ETL pipelines in the Azure Data Factory environment, is it so?
No, DP 200 and DP 201. DP 200 basically talks about in which scenario what services to use. For example, for storage purpose, we have data lake store, we have blob storage, we have Cosmos DB, we have SQL database, we have SQL data warehouse. In which scenario which tool to use? Okay, and how we build a data pipeline using data factories. So yes, in order to use such tools, in order to do hands-on over such tools, we have to use a data factory. Okay, so in DP200, data factory, blob storage, ADL, okay, Cosmos DB, then comes SQL database, and Synapse Analytics. Such type of tools are used there. Okay, but main focus is not to create a data pipeline. Data pipeline is to be created, but one more important focus is in which scenario, which tool to use. Why we will choose a blob storage in a specific scenario, and why we will not prefer going with any other tool there. So technical comparison, performance level comparison, cost level comparison is a part of the DP200. In case of DP201, as we will speak more on DP201, it is basically for architecting solutions. So different types of architectures here we can study. Okay, and in which scenario, in that architecture, at that place, which tool to use. Okay, that kind of study is there in DP200. Okay, so architecting solutions. Sorry, I already have written. Architecting concerns, performance concerns. Security concerns, non-functional concerns. Those are all we talk about in DP201. Have I made the point clear?
Chandrasekhar, sir, I have one more question. So let's say for this data factory you are telling, right? So I was wondering, like, I've seen, like, if we have to practice the data factory, I mean, obviously, generally we don't get the cluster thing and all. So there is a database community edition, right? So there we can practice, that's how I read. And when I am trying to create any account there, it was not allowing me to do that. So is there any other way by which we can practice like PySpark codes over somewhere?
If you want to practice PySpark code, okay, one of the solutions is there is something called as a Databricks available on the Azure Cloud. So if you get a subscription of Azure Cloud, you can use Databricks there, because inside Databricks there is a PySpark engine working. Hello?
Yeah, I was telling that is chargeable, right?
Yes, it is chargeable. I mean to say, yes, you can create a free account also for 1 month.
Yeah, so I was looking something free, like community edition is free. So something like that I was looking.
Otherwise, you know, Spark and PySpark are PySpark. They are open source, freeware. They are open source, freeware. So you can install PySpark there in your machine. You can download it from the website. You can install it, and forever you can try working over there. Okay. So that is one of another way you can do with. Besides that, there are some
Jupyter notebook you are telling, is it?
On
Jupyter notebook we can do that, you are telling.
No. Jupyter notebook allows me to practice Python, but not PySpark.
Okay, so PySpark on which platform we can practice on our local?
With PySpark.
Alone PySpark, you can install it in Windows.
You can use PyCharm along with downloading the drivers or whatever you call it for PySpark.
The editor available. PyCharm is editor available. Okay, yes. Whenever you go with a standalone Spark, you can go with a PyCharm, you can go with a that Spark also, you know, you can do development by using Jupyter at the top of PySpark engine. Besides that, Eclipse does have plugin for that. So you can go with one of these options.
Okay. Yeah, got it. Thank you.
There is that is not for Azure notebook. I was suggesting if that is that also you can try notebook. Now what exactly it is, a free service for Python development. Okay, for Python development, free service for Python development. So that also you can try. So multiple options are available. Okay, to go with this. Have I made this point clear? Anybody have any other question, please? Let me just check. Have I got any message? No. Please save the file and share it with this chap. Yes, that's a good suggestion. I will do that. Okay, I got one more question. Spark data frames. Yes. I already have mentioned data frame here in Pandas. You know, there is a concept of data frame in R language also. Okay, and there is a concept of data frame in Spark. Spark data frame, you know, is similar to Pandas data frame. Although Pandas data frame has a much inherited library, okay, Spark data frame, you know, is using similar semantics and similar kind of library of Pandas data frame. Okay, but Spark data frame internally works in entirely different way. Pandas data frame, you know, the API of Pandas data frame is almost available here in Spark data frame, but internal functioning is entirely different. But being a developer, if you are bothering about the API, okay, and if you have learned Pandas data frame, then working with a Spark data frame is not a big deal for you. You can easily start working with Spark data frame. Any other question, please? I will have 1 5-minute break by 3:35. Okay, 5 minutes break or 10 minutes break, whatever Manish suggests us. Okay, and we will resume our session post to that. Okay, so in case if you are waiting for the break, just wait for next 10-15 minutes. Yes. As far as deep. Yeah, go ahead.
I belong to testing background. So from ETL testing, like that's kind of testing scenarios, like what can I can expect over here?
No, come again with your question.
My question was like in DP 200 and 201, like as I belong to testing background, so what can I expect over here? Topics or anything like that?
Okay, here, you know, DP 200 and DP 201 basically are for, you know, engineer. Data engineer. Okay, so what I told you, if you are from the testing background, aligning yourself to data engineer profile, or you know, reskilling yourself to data engineer profile is not a big deal. Okay, you can easily do it. So if you if you are willing to go for this certification, believe me, not much challenging for you. You can go for this certification. What are all things you will have to get ready upon? I will come to that. And I have in my slides, I have prepared the list of the tools that will be covered in this certification. So at that time, now I will talk about every tool in short. Okay, so there I can bring to your notice which tools, you know, are what purpose. Okay, but otherwise, you know, for this certification, you will have to go through all those tools. And that's not a point that, you know, you will just focus on just few of the tools. No, you will have to focus on all the tools. But what is the important point here in this discussion is that you can go for Python-like language, okay, for the purpose of the customization, for add-on customization. But if you are from testing background, if you are from management background, no, we have lots of such tools which are UI based. Data Factory, for example, it is UI based. There are some, you know, a Power BI that also works as a, you know, data wrangling tool. That also can be a data wrangling tool. As your ML service, is not a part of this curriculum, but there is another examination, DP 100, you know, which is actually based on Azure ML service. Using Azure ML service, if you are not from Python background or any programming language background, look, creating different machine language models becomes very easy. All UI based, you know, arrangements are given there. So doing analytics and advanced analytics and machine learning and deep learning, you know, becomes very simple even if you are from non-development background. Have I made this point clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Whole curriculum has been divided into these three parts. Here you will see detailed curriculum. You can see at this level, I am just mentioning this URL in chat box. So you can get that detailed curriculum from that URL. Yeah, I have shared that URL. I just start the slideshow. Okay. So non-relational cloud data storages means blob storage, data lake store, Cosmos DB is NoSQL like storage. Relational cloud storages means SQL database, data warehouse, you know, where you can join two tables and procure the data. So in this first section, which has maximum weightage of 40 to 45%, okay, you have to work on blob storage, data lake store. I will cover that list soon, and Cosmos DB in relational category, SQL database also. Different data processing solution, it means where you will have to write the code and that code will be processed, or you will simply do some drag and drop and, you know, that processing will be done. Okay, that is a part of the processing, and here you will see Databricks. Databricks basically is for analytical processing. Stream analytics, Databricks like tools are being covered here. So Databricks also does have stream analytics. I mean to say Databricks also can do batch processing as well as the stream processing. In addition to that, there is a stream analytics service available on the cloud, okay, which is, you know, explicitly for stream analytical processing. Okay, so you know, study of these two things has been covered here, and here you will see Databricks allows me batch processing, Databricks allows me stream processing also. Okay, so you know, out of 25 to 30%, 20 to 25% weightage is always on Databricks. That's why whenever we conduct the trainings for the certification, we focus much more on Databricks, because there are many questions coming in examination on Databricks. So when we conduct such a certification courses, our focus is on Databricks. Databricks ingesting data from variety of the data sources, and you know, egressing data to variety of the data sources. So keeping Databricks at the center, you know, we do lots of hands-on in the certification programs that we run. Besides that, in order to secure the data, in order to secure the compute, what are all different methods available? What do you mean by access key? How we can use access key to mount the storage? How can we use SAS token to mount the data lake store? How can we use service principle, you know, to provide the R-restricted access to the storage devices or data sources or data sync? Okay, so different security measures are being covered here in this particular section. Okay, so that's how your whole curriculum has been divided into three parts. Okay, and list of the tools in all these three parts, that list I'm mentioning in the separate slide. Okay, but otherwise whole curriculum has been divided into these three parts. Different Azure services which you need to work upon to get ready for the examination, and you know, to improve your profile as a data engineer. Storage account, data lake store, both these are, you know, pure storages only. Databricks is a storage plus compute. Now for working with the Databricks, you need PySpark. And that was the question what was asked to me. Okay, how to work with a PySpark, okay, without portal or without subscription. So you can do installation of standalone installation on your machine. You get Windows installable, you get Linux installable, and single instance you can create on your machine. Okay, creating two instances to check, you know, parallel processing, partitioning, and all those things again is very simple. You don't have to have, you know, Hadoop cluster all the time up and running. Without a Hadoop cluster also, you can install PySpark in your local machine. You can create more than one instances in your local machine. Okay, and there you can see how on multiple instances you know, your data frames are processed. Okay, so standalone installation is possible. Databricks. Data factory is for ETL operations. Databricks also can do, you know, ETL operations. Okay, so let me just prepare another list now. Here, let me prepare a list. Storages. Blob storage, file storage, okay, and data lake store, yes. Then comes queryable storages, because both these storages are not queryable. So we have to have, you know, another category of storages, queryable storages, where our resultant data will go. And this resultant data will be queried by your customer base or user base. Queryable storages, SQL database, Then comes dedicated SQL pool. We used to call it as a Synapse Analytics earlier. Or before that, you know, it was called SQL Data Warehouse. But now it is being called as a dedicated SQL pool. These are queryable storages. So in case if you want to pick up a raw data, use this storage. This storage will hold the raw data. Okay, and this storage can supply the raw data to your compute. Okay, after your compute has processed that data, move that data to the queryable storage. So user base can, you know, query that, those results, that analysis can be queryable. Okay, if you keep on these. What are all different computes available? So here you will see for batch processing, because there are two types of computes here in analytics. Batch processing. There we have, you know, Azure Databricks. Okay, and for stream processing. And here we also have another arrangement. Data lake analysis. Okay, stream processing, again Databricks. Databricks allows me a stream processing also. Azure Stream Analytics, that is also allowed. Okay, besides this, you know, similar kind of arrangements are available there on HD Insight. Okay, so HD Insight, we have to separately compare. Cover it. Besides this, whenever you want to manage. Sorry, something you want to say? Is it time for a break? Let me just check, is it time for break?
Yes, sir, after break and
okay, I have 3-4 minutes in hand. Okay, one more queryable storage I forgot to mention here, Cosmos DB. Okay, it is also queryable storage. As far as computes are concerned, these are different, you know, compute solutions available. Okay, then comes ETL tools, ETL. Now for ETL purpose, again Databricks comes there, So Databricks is versatile and unified platform to offer you many solutions at one place. Okay, so for ETL, we have Databricks. We have Data Factory also. So that also we can use. Okay, in order to manage security, we have Azure Active Directory. In order to, you know, monitor all the the tools, all services for their health check, for their status of running, we have Azure Monitor. Okay, and here as far as ETL or Logic Apps also, let me mention Logic Apps. So it's not ETL, it is beyond ETL. Okay, Logic Apps basically is for managing complete workflow, including data workflow also. Okay, but here I just mention it under the ETL, or let me change its name, workflow management. Workflow management. So there I can talk about data workflow, data factory, ETL, Databricks, and complete workflow, end-to-end workflow, Logic Apps. So other tools available, those tools I have listed here: Active Directory, subscription management, key vault for maintaining secrets. Okay, for stream analytics, there is an event hub. So all these tools we will have to cover in this curriculum. We have to get up and ready in working with all these tools. Okay, and in 3 days certification course, we work on all these tools. Yes. I think it is a time for us to take a break now. Okay, post break, I will begin with what exactly the examination format is and other things. Okay, so let me just check with Manish. Manish, are you there?
Yes, yes, I am there.
So Manish, I have got a couple of questions. Okay. Which I will talk post break now. Okay, so what is queue storage? What is table storage? I will talk on them post break. In the break,
meanwhile, I'm sharing.
How much time would you give? Would you be giving to us?
Yes, it's only I require only 5 minutes. Okay, for presentation.
Okay, so 10 minutes break then I will have. So 5 minutes what you will consume and 5 minutes for whole team. Fine?
Yes, yes, sure.
Yes, yes.
Can you hear me? Everything can see my screen?
Everyone? Yes, Manish.
Yes, Manish, we can see your screen.
Okay, okay.
Yes.
Here is something important that I want to share share today. I assume you all are active on LinkedIn, right?
So,
yes, Anish.
Okay. We know there are two important section available under LinkedIn profile. First is license and certification, and next is skilling and endorsement. Okay. In license and certification, here you can add any of your certification which you have done recently. Okay. Okay. Next is skills and endorsement. Okay, where you can add your skills, technical skills or non-technical skills. For example, as you are attending these today's sessions, DP201. Okay, so you can add any relevant tech keywords. Like DP201, data engineer, or Microsoft Azure, or Microsoft data, data. This type of keywords you can using your skills and endorsement sections. Once you add your new skills into your account, your profile will be get updated, and it reaches to the relevant professionals who belongs to the same technology. Okay. Here are some benefits I can share with you. Okay. The step one is Microsoft announced. Microsoft announced a special raffle contest where one lucky winner could win Microsoft Surface laptop every month. Okay. To get eligible for this contest, all you have to just update your skills, which I have explained earlier, and fill your basic details on the link which I am sharing in chat box. Okay, Don't miss this chance updating your skills with hardly, it take only hardly 5 minutes. Okay, so please update your skills on your LinkedIn. And for your better understanding, watch this video. One second, I'm sharing one video for this.
Who are some of your favorite superheroes? Maybe it's Wonder Woman, Batman, or the Black Panther. Superheroes have superpowers, things they can do really well.
Can everyone hear the sound?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, that no other superhero can. Well, you have these too, and they're called skills. So why is it important to add key skills to your LinkedIn profile? Adding skills to your profile allows you to highlight your abilities, strengths, and expertise, and to build your credibility among peers, colleagues, managers, and even recruiters. Why? Because a third party validating the skill sets you say you have helps to build trust in your professional experience. And adding key skills lets others find you more easily. In fact, members with 5 or more skills listed are discovered up to 27 times more in searches on LinkedIn and receive up to 17 times more profile views. Now let's talk about endorsements. Once you add a skill to your profile, that skill can be endorsed by your professional community. Keep in mind, only your first degree connections can endorse you for a skill. So why do endorsements matter to you? When a connection endorses you for a skill, it strengthens your profile and increases the likelihood that you'll be discovered for opportunities related to your skills. Pretty great, right? On LinkedIn, you're in full control of all the skills and endorsements within your profile. Let's go ahead and check out endorsement settings to make sure they are adjusted to your liking. Let's dive into James's profile so we can see how endorsements show up. First, we'll scroll down to the skills and endorsements section of his profile. Next, James will need to make sure that his endorsement settings are adjusted to his liking. He'll do this by simply clicking into the pencil to edit, clicking on adjust endorsement settings, and switching the toggle to make sure that the settings are adjusted to how he wants. For James, he wants to see suggestions to endorse his connections, so he'll simply flip the toggle on. Then he'll X out. Did you know that LinkedIn automatically pulls the top 3 skills you've received the most endorsements on and displays them within your profile? That's what you're seeing here in James's profile. If you want to see more skills at any time, simply click Show More. And you'll see all the different skills that you've received endorsements on and that you've listed within your profile. You can adjust your top 3 at any time, and James would like to change the top 3 skills that he has listed in his profile. To do this, he'll simply click into the pencil to edit and either unpin the skill or pin it back up if that's what he wants to see listed within his top skills, and then click Save. As you evolve in your career, make sure you update your top 3 skills to reflect the new skill sets you've acquired. Also, did you know that you don't have to accept endorsements that don't support your career journey? To hide a skill endorsement, simply click into the skill on your profile and switch the visibility toggle off for any people who you don't want endorsing you for that skill. For James, he doesn't want to see this endorsement from Daniel. So he'll simply switch the visibility toggle off and save. This will make it so that endorsement doesn't appear on his profile from Daniel. Lastly, here's some final nuggets for you. When adding skills to your profile, make sure to add a broad range of hard and soft skills that support your professional brand. Have awesome Microsoft PowerPoint skills? Add that. What about the fact that you have skills in robotics or Python? That can be added to your profile too. Maybe you have incredible leadership or coaching skills. Add that as well. Don't forget, LinkedIn will categorize your skills into expertise areas based on industry knowledge, tools and technology, interpersonal skills, languages, and other skills you have. You can add a maximum of 50 skills to your profile that represent you. Start building credibility and add 5 or more skills that represent the amazing professional that is you.
Yes, here is chance for you to win Microsoft Surface Go laptop. So please update your skill on LinkedIn and simply register. I have already shared a link in chat box. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks. And please, before leaving, please fill the feedback form, because we have one more surprise for you. So please, before leaving the session, please fill your feedback form. Feedback form link also share with in chat box. Okay.
Thanks, Manish.
Okay. Thank you.
So I'm sharing my screen. So let us understand quickly the pattern of the examination before I move ahead. I got a couple of questions. First of all, let me just quickly address them. So queue storage, table storage, Cosmos DB, whether it is queryable, and then. Okay, I have got 3 questions. So let me quickly explain about those questions. Answer those questions. So storage account has, you know, mainly 4 parts: blob storage, file storage, queue storage, and table storage. I also got some question, I think. Let me just check. Link of feedback form has been shared. Okay. Here, you know, we use this blob storage to store objects. Okay, file storage is used whenever there are multiple virtual machines and these virtual machines want to share something among them. So file is a shareable storage. You know, this file can be mounted as a drive in the local machine also and on the VMs also. So multiple VMs can, you know, mount the file storage as a drive, and basically its purpose is to exchange the data. Okay, queue is not for the storage basically. It is for 2 web applications to exchange the messages. So one web application, if it's sending some message to another web application, you know, in between these 2 applications, queue can work. Web applications or enterprise applications. Enterprise applications, we can say here. Okay, so it is not basically to store the data. Table storage. Now, table storage basically is a key value pair or key value storage. Key value storage. Key value storage. Okay, and storage. Just let me mention very important point about the table storage, which may help you whenever you work on some project or whenever you work on floor. Okay, whenever you receive the data with very high velocity, data coming from IoT devices, data coming from, not IoT devices, I will say, logs of the servers, data whenever it's coming from the logs of the server, the velocity of the data is always very high. Not all storages, all other storages can offer you adequate write speed to write that data. Even Cosmos DB also may not offer you that much speed, you know, to write each and every data without loss of any data, whatever be the, you know, velocity of the data. In such scenarios, these key value storages are very important. What they do is every record is identified by key, and actual content of the data, actual content of that record go there in the binary format without any kind of conversion. Okay, so data goes there in the binary format, and that's why it has very high read write speed. Okay, so when you receive the data with very high speed and there, if you realize that moving that data to the Cosmos DB or moving that data to any other NoSQL database, you know, is taking time, okay, and mismatching with the velocity of the incoming data, there you can go with table storage. So for very high velocity of data. Velocity of data. As far as Cosmos DB is concerned, okay, it comes in multiple flavors. I mean to say multiple APIs. You know, so SQL API is there, Mongo API is there, Gremlin API is there, Cassandra API is there, multiple types.
Hello, Chandrasekhar sir, you are not audible. Hello, Chandrasekhar sir. Hello.
I think there is some network connection issue.
Yeah, maybe.
Yes, yes, I'm calling him. One second.
I'm audible there.
Yes, now yes, sir.
Yes, I regret for this disruption. Yes, so I'm sharing the screen again. Whether my screen is reaching to all of you?
Yes, screen is reaching.
Yes. Okay. So SQL and MongoDB databases, though they offer me Mongo API, SQL database can run queries also.
I got a question here. Cosmos DB itself is a database type. Then why you are taking different type of DB in the Cosmos DB? Are these are the different replacement of the Cosmos DB, or how it is correlated with Cosmos DB?
No, one Cosmos DB can offer you different data models. All these are data models. So document database is one data model it offers. Gremlin basically is a graph data model. So one Cosmos DB can offer you multiple data models. And there are data models who are, quickly queryable. There are data models, in front of which you can write a Mongo wrapper and it can, be interacted with a Mongo API. Gremlin is graph data model. Cassandra is columnar data model. Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
So Chandrasekhar sir, so this Cosmos DB at the back end, how it stores the data, it stores in a NoSQL format, right? And then on top of that, we have all these APIs to query it.
No, it doesn't store every kind of data in a single format. In case if you have chosen one of these two models, it will store the data in the form of the document database. If you have chosen, Gremlin data model in the Cosmos DB, then it will store your data into the graph form. So whenever you are creating a database there, at that time you have to choose with what data model do you want it to go with, and that API you can use.
So if we choose SQL, the data will be stored in relational format database, right?
No, in document DB, JSON data format.
Okay. JSON data. Even if we are choosing the SQL, is it? Then also it will be in JSON format.
Yes, yes.
For okay.
This format is same. So whenever you are choosing SQL, in front of that you can write Mongo wrapper. Whenever you are choosing Mongo, you can still do say, query it by using SQL, because down the line data goes into the same format. It's a document database. But that is not the case with a graph or columnar data model. Graph and columnar data model cannot be queried through SQL API. Cannot be queried through SQL API.
So this graph means it will be just like Neo4j, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So Neo4j like. And a CouchDB, I think, is a customer, is a columnar data model, is it? CouchDB, can somebody correct me?
Yes, correct. Yeah.
CouchDB like. Okay. So I think I have answered the questions. What were posted to me? Have I received any new question? No, I haven't received any new question. So let us go back and see what is examination pattern. So let me start this slideshow. Examination is of around 3 hours. One thing, let me make it clear. Since last year, I have started giving examination from my home. Everybody can give examination from the home. The only thing is you have to have proper arrangements and proper decorum. What do you mean by proper arrangement? You have to have your own laptop, which is not in the network of your company. Even if it is a company laptop, you have to, you know, start this examination into incognito mode or into in private mode, so that it will not be examination will not be in company network or under the shadow of the proxy server of the company. So that care you will have to take. Your laptop, you know, will have latest browser that and Pearson's browser also. Pearson's also adds its own browser in your machine whenever we are making our machine ready for the examination. You have to have, you know, separate isolated seating arrangement. Okay, that is one thing. And another thing is for the period of the examination, you can't allow anybody around you. Okay, you have to isolate yourself. You have to lock yourself in the room for 3-4 hours. Okay, and then you have to appear for the examination. So proper decorum you have to maintain there. There are around 45 to 55 questions to be appeared in the 3 hours. Okay, now here I have mentioned 180 minutes. Here I have mentioned 210 minutes. So 15 minutes before actual examination to begin, we have to log in and we have to stay there for 15 minutes after you complete the examination. So that's why 210 minutes are mentioned there. But exact examination, exact duration of the examination is of 3 hours. All questions will be of MCQ type. There will not be any question on development, write code or something like that. Options will be given. You have to choose accurate option. Most of the questions are single choice. In case if there are 50 questions, around 44 to 45 questions will be of single choice. Excuse me. There may be 4 or 5 questions which may be of the multiple choice. Okay, but otherwise, and wherever there are multiple choice questions, it is always mentioned there. Okay, in the question, it is always mentioned that find 2 suitable choices, find 3 suitable choices. So that count is always mentioned there. Few questions are multi-choice, with each correct choice has its own weightage. Very few questions, 1 or 2, just 1 or 2 questions, you know, which are multiple choice, and whole weightage will be given only when all choices are correct. Only when all choices are correct, then only whole weightage is given. very few questions are like sequencing. So there may be 4 or 5 steps are mentioned. You simply have to arrange them in proper sequence, like creating the pipeline in the data factory. Okay, so create a linked service, create a data set, create a pipeline, add activity. Such type of steps are mentioned. You simply have to arrange them in proper order. Okay, if they are not in order, you can appear for examination from home. No negative marking. So don't leave any question unattempted. Attempt every question. Okay, and there is no development or there is no code writing. Yes. Examination may be divided into 3 parts. One thing let me just mention as a disclaimer, you know, they keep changing the pattern. Okay, so whatever pattern I am mentioning here, okay, may not be there tomorrow, but there is no major change in the pattern. Always remember, there will be some slight change in the pattern. Section 1, it is based on one big case study. Okay, a case study will be given, and on that case study, you will be asked a couple of questions. So they may be mentioning some real life scenario, and on that scenario, they may ask you the question like, how can we make the data to reach to customer base when our customer base is spreaded all over the world? My customer base is spreaded all over the world. There are customers in US and there are customers in Southeast Asia. How can we, you know, make possible to reach the data into US and at the same time into Southeast Asia? At the same time into Southeast Asia. So then you have to choose an answer like Cosmos DB or such type of questions may be asked. Okay, so 5-10 questions are based on that case study. So one case study on that, you know, 5 to 10 questions will be based. There may be smaller case studies in the now for this case study, your questions are not navigatable. It means whenever you are appearing the first question, okay, be sure about the answer, read it twice before you go to the second question, because once you go to the second question, you cannot come back to the first question. So these questions are not navigatable. But in section 2, questions are navigatable. One small case study will be given, but this is small case study. In section 1, if they are giving you case study of, you know, 2 pages, in section 2, case study will have half the page only. And on that small, you know, scenario, there will be 3-4 questions asked. And these 3-4 questions are navigatable. So after attempting third question, if you see the answer you have given for the first question, you can go back and you can reappear, recorrect that answer. So in this section, you will see questions are navigatable. Okay, but you can do navigation within those 3-4 questions only. And then in there comes the section 3. Section 3 is the simplest here. Okay, I did find, you know, section 1 little bit difficult because reading that 2-page wala case study and remembering all the facts there, okay, before I go for answering, you know, becomes difficult. That's why. Okay, question section 3, no case study at all. Only questions about your conceptual understanding. Only questions about your conceptual understanding. So questions can be, how much RUs you will select for making Cosmos DB scalable? Now, whenever you learn and whenever you work on Cosmos DB, this becomes very important point. Okay, and answering this point becomes very simple because this point has been highlighted into the study material. Okay, that whenever you declare 1000 RUs for Cosmos DB, Cosmos DB becomes scalable. Below that, Cosmos DB has limitations of scaling. But above 1000 RUs, Cosmos DB becomes easily scalable. Such type of questions may be asked. What are maximum size of the cluster created in Synapse Analytics service? Maximum size of the cluster created in Synapse Analytics. Now, Synapse Analytics is for mass parallel processing. Maximum size of the cluster is 60. Such type of questions are asked. I will be discussing a couple of such questions by end of our discussion. Okay, few hints to go for the examination. Sometimes after reading the question, you normally go to find the answer. Sometimes when you realize the question is difficult to understand, you have to apply reverse engineering. You have to identify answers first. And from the answer, then you have to go to the question. So sometimes you may have to apply reverse engineering. These are tips and tricks of appearing for the examination. I don't think you will need them. I am reading them quickly. Do not assume anything like, whenever the question is on cost reduction, do not bother about performance. So don't assume that if you reduce this cost, you know, what will be the performance? Do not bother about it, because they want you to answer for cost reduction. Then you have to choose a suitable service without bothering about the performance. So don't assume that, you know, they will bother about performance, rather they are asking about cost reduction. No. Apply your best logic. Try to reserve, try to complete your examination in 2.5 hours only. And yes, means you will realize that examination can be completed into 2.5 hours. And you can extract, you know, half an hour to go through or review all the questions. Mark the question for review. You don't have to note down anywhere. There is always a button on at the top of every question. Okay, you can click that button. You can check that button to mark it as a question to review later. So after you appear for all the questions, then it gives you the list of the questions you have marked for review. And it will take you back to those questions, okay, which you have marked for review. So you can revisit those questions. Conceptual understanding and hands-on are necessary. Questions are not based on memory. Okay, mostly questions are based on conceptual understanding, but there are some, you know, facts which are very important. Okay, those facts are to be remembered, like maximum size of the cluster of synapse 300 eggs and maximum threshold from thereafter, you know, Cosmos DB starts of scaling. Such type of figures you have to remember. There are figures which may change in future, like, you know, maximum storage capacity of blob storage. They will not ask you that question. Earlier it was 500 TB. Now it is 1000 TB. I recently heard that it has been made 1200 TB. So there will not be questions on such figures. Because for the figures, there is no specific and correct and answer for all the time. Such questions are avoided from there. Questions may be twisted. I have realized that more the question is twisted, easy to answer it. They simply twist the question to make it look like difficult. Simple, very simple question, they twist and make it difficult. Most of the time, at the first instance, questions look difficult or out of curriculum. But if you observe carefully, it is simple, very simple. These are the topics you need to work upon, you know, for appearing for DP201 examination. These are different architectures. We normally cover all these architectures in our classroom sessions. And inside of these architectures, which architecture is to be, you know, suitable in with what kind of scenario, that kind of discussion is a part of this curriculum. These are the topics. I will mark them as you know, important topics for the sake of the examination. You will be given whenever you appear, whenever you attend any training on the certification, you will be given MOC, material of content, study material you get from Microsoft. You know, that material you have to carefully read, but you cannot limit yourself to that material only. What you have to do is you have to, you know, do some extra work. Beyond that material, in that material, there are URLs specified. You have to visit those URLs and you have to read some extra. Okay, so that is very important to get ready for examinations. Question paper weightage is of 1000. Okay, and passing is 700. You must score at least 700 to get past this examination. These questions, I will come back to them just few minutes later. I'm just bypassing them. I will revisit the slides later. Now, what is happening is, specifically since last year, you know, we have stopped conducting classroom trainings because, you know, we bother about, our company bothers about trainer's health as well as participants and attendees' health. So traveling was not comfortable. Social distancing had to be maintained. As on today also, the cases in Pune and Mumbai have crossed, you know, alarming level. And again, you know, slowly things are coming to stand still. So everything is now happening through work from home. So in this scenario, what we have done is, we have introduced, you know, instructor-led training. These are online trainings what we are running. These trainings are interactive. The way by which, you know, I am maintaining this PowerPoint slide. Okay, we do mention each and every notes here. These notes are shared with you. So these trainings are interactive. Okay, as I am saying interactive, let me check, have I received any message? No, as of now, I haven't received any message. Huh. So these trainings are interactive. Even, you know, after attending these trainings offer you free Azure subscription. These trainings offer you, say, passes for appearing for the examination. Okay, discounted passes for appearing for the examination. So you can register yourself for the examination. Okay, you can choose any time slot. Okay, and you can appear from home for the examination. You don't have to, you know, search for any pro matrix center, okay, and appear for the examination. Synergetics is actually, you know, pioneering in this area, and we have started introducing lots of such solutions. So persona based onboarding solution. Persona based means training for data scientists only, training for AI engineers only. So persona based training also we do offer. Persona-based reskilling we offer. So if you are college passed out, onboarding persona-based trainings are there. If you are already in the with some role like, you know, database administrator, okay, you can go for these reskilling trainings where you can add into your skill set another title as a data engineer. Okay, different certification trainings, practice development trainings, emerging technology solutions also, lots of emerging technologies we are introducing here, and we do conduct trainings for that also. VILT, virtual instructor-led training, is a trend as on today. This trend is not something new. It is new in India, but otherwise this trend is already there in US. Okay, so we have to begin that trend in India where, you know, trainer will be at home, participants will be at their homes, okay, and you know, training will happen online. Lots of VILT features here. We limit the size. Okay, we do not allow the size of the batch to be more than 25 participants. We drive these trainings full hands-on. So right from the first moment, we start introducing hands-on. And concepts and hands-ons, we make possible to go hand in hand. Okay, so trainer only share the screen. Participants keep posting their messages into chat, and trainer go back to the chat window and answer those questions. Trainer use pen brush or something like tool, you know, to draw the diagrams, to do the concept visualization. So this training is driven, you know, hands-on and concept understanding hand-to-hand. About Microsoft examination, I already have told you at this URL, curriculum of just a minute. Let me just share that URL with you. Curriculum of the examination you can see from here. If you want to, you know, appear for the examination, you have to schedule the examination. That is also possible. No, one webcam and that two of the laptop is sufficient. Okay, Microsoft even, you know, restrict you of using any other laptop in the same room. You must not have laptop in the same, another laptop in the same room. So what you have to do is before you start the examination, you have to, you know, log in for the examination, and you have to show the complete ambience to the proctor. That proctor, you know, asks you to show him the complete ambience in the room. Okay, and there are arrangements to, you know, completely observe all the time, observe your eye movements, your lip movements, all these arrangements are there. I do have a habit to, when I think, I may not look at the screen, I try to look outside window. But that proctor did ask me to look into the screen only, not anywhere else. So they keep monitoring our eye movements, our lip movements, okay, everything they keep monitoring. But one laptop, one webcam is sufficient or is restricted to. Have I answered that question? Hello, Ms. Pooja, have I answered that question? Okay, this is the original Microsoft page where you will see information regarding the curriculum of the examination. What you have to do is, whenever you schedule the examination, you get mail on the same email ID which you have registered with the Microsoft. You get mail in that mailbox. In that mailbox, all steps are mentioned. What you will do, what you will do as a second step, what you will do as a third step. So there is one step called as a system check. So when you click on that hyperlink, you know, it downloads the browser in your machine. Sorry, it downloads one installable in your machine. You simply have to quickly install that software. That software works like a browser. And yes, that browser you will have to use to do the examination. What I do suggest you, in case you have a time slot of 9 a.m. for the examination, okay, always try to log in 15 minutes early, because I have realized those 15 minutes are very necessary, you know, to begin with the examination. You know, I have to upload my identification from my mobile. I have to show ambience to the proctor. You know, lots of activities I have to do within that 15 minutes. Okay, and if I join late, examination will also start late. Avoid starting up the examination late. Okay, always join 15 minutes before the examination. Okay, so all the steps are mentioned in that mail. You simply have to follow those steps. And following those steps is not a big deal. Can we use our company laptop? Yes, you can use your company laptop, but one thing you will have to do, you will appear for the examination from incognito window or in private window. Okay, from that window, if you appear for the examination, then, you know, the communication that will happen from your laptop up to the server will not be done through proxy server of your company. Okay, so. A company and laptop is possible, but then in that case, you will have to, you know, do appear for the examination through incognito window. System requirements are also not big. You know, ordinary window operating system you will have to have, recent window operating system you will have to have, and it can be 4GB machine also. A 4GB machine is also sufficient. Okay, so all the system requirements are also mentioned there in that mail. Okay, so that's all here about the system requirement. Appearing for the examination is not a big deal. Just one day before, you just ensure to check your system, okay, by clicking on the hyperlink in their email, so that, you know, that in your email they provide system check hyperlink. If you click there, you know, automatically your system is checked whether your audio is working properly or not, whether your video of your machine is working properly or not. These are mandatory things. Audio and video both these things are always on whenever you are appearing for the examination. Okay, and every sound around you is captured there. So they have to ensure the proper decorum is being mentioned. Just few questions I will quickly go through to bring to your notice the pattern of the examination, pattern of the questions. So here you observe, you are evaluating data storage solution to support a new application. You want to, you know, choose new data storage solution. You need to recommend a data storage solution that represents data by using nodes and relationships in the graph structure. You want to represent data in the graph structure. No, in order to represent data in the graph structure, you know, we have very few choices like Neo4j. Here in Cosmos DB, we have Gremlin API, a Gremlin storage. Okay, so what kind of data storage solution would you recommend? So it is Cosmos DB. So Cosmos DB is multi-model data service with a Gremlin API for managing graph structures. Such type of window will not be there in the examination. This type of window, they will not be there in the examination. Okay, this is what I am just explaining you the answer to the problem. Okay, so Cosmos DB is the correct answer here. So such type of questions are mentioned there. Okay, and there may be, you know, radio buttons in front of them. So you have to choose appropriate radio button. If it is single choice, there will be radio buttons. If it is a multiple choice question, there will be check boxes. Okay. You are designing data processing solution that will implement Lambda architecture pattern. Now in 2021, we specifically focus on explanation of Lambda architecture. Okay, the solution will use Spark running on HD Insight for data processing. You need to recommend a data storage technology for the solution. So for Lambda architecture, what combination will you use? That is what it is being asked. Which two technologies should you recommend? Each correct answer presents the complete solution. So data storage technology you want to choose here. So it will be data processing technology. It will be Kafka HD Insight. Okay, and Cosmos DB for offering multi-model. No negative mark for all certifications. There is no negative marking for this for any question. Okay, and so enjoy. Don't leave even a single question unattempted. Okay, so such type of questions are there. See, there may be some diagram given. Now this is modern warehouse architecture, we call it as. Okay, and in this architecture, there is one component missing from here. So here is a Azure blob storage. Okay, that data will be processed here. Okay, and there is another processing engine to be given here to prepare reports. And those reports can be prepared on Power BI. So what kind of, you know, service you will use, which can do analytics and prepare reports for us? So here we have to choose actual and appropriate answer. Appropriate answer is D here. Azure Synapse Analytics. Okay, I should have mentioned that answer. Let me just mark it as a red line. Yes. Okay, read the question, see the diagram, and find the answer which is mentioned there. And hereafter, I would like to request to you for the questions if you have. And whenever you are dropping yourself, okay, please fill up the feedback. So let us begin question answer session. We will go with the question answer session for within last 5 minutes. Yes, questions please. So I think let us wrap up the schedule. I haven't seen any question. I will be waiting for your question in next 5 minutes. Okay, you can keep posting the questions to me. Okay, but my humble request is before you leave the meeting, just please fill up the feedback form. Submit your feedback, please.
Yeah, I have a question. DP201 is getting retired, I think.
Yes.
The message posted. So you can give more info on that.
Yeah, it will be retiring in coming July, August. And they are introducing new examination, DP203. That will be based on the curriculum of DP200 and DP201. Okay, so they are combining these two curriculums and introducing a single examination, DP203. This examination is in the beta stage as of now, and full-fledged examination is expected to be introduced by end of this month. We will be commencing certification courses on DP203 from April. Thanks, Mr. Bhaskar. Hope this session is useful to you.
Is this certification can be taken directly without prior any other certification is required?
Yes, but what I suggest you is DP200 study is helpful in DP201. It is helpful. You directly can go for DP201 without even going for DP200. But my experience is, anyway, for DP201, you need to study a part of DP200 also. So you can go for you can appear for DP200 examination and then go for DP201.
There is one question, Chandrasekhar. Bharat Kumar here. So what yes. I was asking you is, to appear this exam, do we have any study material or do we have any URL or the portal where we can conduct this test practice?
Yes, I already have shared one URL to you.
Okay.
On that URL, you will find some videos also. But okay. Actual Microsoft study material will be shared to you. Okay. When you appear for the courses, for the courses, Microsoft allows us to share links to those materials.
Okay. Sure.
So thanks, Mr. Karthikeyan. Thanks, Ms. Pooja, for your comments. Okay. And any other question? Yes, Manish. Over to you, Manish.
Okay,
thank you. Sir, for attending the exam?
Sorry.
What is the fee structure of this to write
the exam? Fee structure is also given into that URL. The URL that I have shared with you, Microsoft webpage URL for that certification. Fee structure is also mentioned there. But if you go for the certification course, you are offered with some discount. In that case, fee structure will be discounted one.
In 17,500 you can get this course plus exam voucher and MOC. Okay.
MOC means study material.
Yes. MOC is study material and exam vouchers also. You can attend through this voucher.
One attempt is allowed through that voucher.
Yes.
So what will be the duration, the time limit within which this voucher can be used?
After your training, you can in 1 year period,
Okay, thanks.
Anyone has any question? Okay, thank you, Chandrasekhar sir, for this wonderful session on Azure Data Solutions DP201 certification. Also, thank you everyone for joining this today's webinar.
Okay. See, they have asked me this paintbrush file. So how can I share this file to you?
Just print screen and share in chat box.
Okay.
Okay.
Print screen and here. Yes, I have shared it, huh? So shall I drop myself now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can.
Thanks all. Thanks all for your cooperation. Huh? Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Here is the certificate for today's webinar attendee for you, which just fill the feedback form. Okay. And also, sir, special surprise for you. Okay. So please fill your feedback form before leaving. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.